Now, this is one of my favourite books in the library. This is the Nuremberg Chronicle, printed in 1493 in Nuremberg, and it's a history of the world, basically a chronicle. And as you can see, it's a really big, serious book. It's got great big, heavy, boards, and the paper is really high quality. When printing first starts in the 1450s, the normal print run would be about 500 books, but the Nuremberg Chronicle was so popular they actually printed 2,500, which is quite a big difference to 500. What that means is, although it's an old book, it's not a particularly rare book. There's a lot of them around, but that doesn't stop it from being a really exciting, dramatic book. And as I said, it's a history of the world. And of course, the world in 1493 starts with creation. This is the hand of God creating the moon, the stars, the sun. And here's Adam. And then later on, we get Eve squeezing her way out of Adam. And it just goes on like this throughout the book. It really is absolutely wonderful. It's the first time that illustration has been extensively used in a book of this age. Then we have Noah's Ark. And this is fun. This is pictures taken from Pliny's Natural History of the World. It's all the people you're going to meet as you travel around the world. And of course, they don't know. Half the world is unexplored at this point, so you can put in who you like. So you have men with wolf's heads, and you have monopods, men with just one foot, and men there with their legs on backwards, which I have no idea why you'd ever want your legs on backwards, but there you go. And this is a map of the world. And the map of the world in 1493 is quite different to our world now. So no Australasia, there's no Scandinavia, and there's also no America, although in 1493 Columbus had actually done his thing, but it didn't appear here. There's around about 1,300 images in here, but they only had 800 wood blocks. So you get a lot of repetition. So for instance here, this is the story of Troy. This is Hercules, Hector and Agamemnon. Now, if you look at Hercules, you see he's got his little fez on. And there he is. But if you look a few pages in, there he is again. Only this time he's at Adias the prophet. And so it goes on, and Hercules just keeps popping up again and again. This is a nice one. This is the first depiction of somebody wearing glasses that was printed. It had been in portraits, but you'd never seen it actually in print before. Nope. And there's Hercules again. He's now a heretic. So he's been Hercules, he's been a prophet, and he's now a heretic. And the book just goes on and on with these beautiful illustrations. There's a wonderful dance of death at the end to remind us all that in the midst of life and all that, and then a day of judgment also. Now, the book survives because the paper is really high quality and it's large. Large books do survive. It's when books get small that they don't. And the Minster is very lucky to have a copy, and I love it.